The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 10th chapter, text number 2 and 3, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in January 1967 in New York.
Name Vidusudagana Prabhavang Namaharsaya Ahamadidhi Devanang Maharsinancha Sarvasa. So Lord Krishna says that nobody knows him. Aham Adihi Devana. If you what you speak of the human society, even you take the demigods who are more intelligent and more advanced than the human society in other planets, they also do not know. And Maharshaya. Maharshaya means that seven great sages, their planet is near the pole star. You have seen it, that like asking questions, seven stars. So these stars are different planets for different great sages. They also do not know. So Name Vidusudagana Prabhavangana Maharshaya Aham Adirhi Devana. I am the source of all these Maharshaya, all these demigods. He is the father of everyone. Maharsinanja Sarvas. I am not only the origin of these demigods, but I am also the origin of all these great sages. That means he is the origin of this universe. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is very nicely described how the universal form took place and how Brahma was created, and from Brahma the rishis were created, how population increased generally. These descriptions are there. So actually, he is the origin. Janmadrasya jata, as it is said in the Vedanta Sutra, everything emanating from him. So, he is also, according to this verse, he is also origin of Paramatma, the super soul. And he is also the origin of Nirvishesh or impersonal Brahma Jyoti. Because it is said, Aham Adihi Devanang Maharshinancha Sarvas. Sarvas means anything that you have any conception of all them, I am the Supreme Soul. Therefore, as it is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam, the absolute truth is realized in three phases. That Madanti tat tattavida tatyam jat jadhyanam advayam. Advayam means non-duality. One, the one supreme truth, absolute truth is realized in three phases. Brahmeti, Paramatmiti, Bhagavaniti, Sabdati. Realization, I mean personal, Brahman, or the glowing effulgence, just like sunshine, then the localized super soul, then Bhagavan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And there are many expansions of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Narayan, Adhokhaja, there are many innumerable planets in the spiritual world, and all of them are emanation from the Krishna planet, and the Krishna planet, the Supreme Deity is Krishna. This description we have got in several Vedic literature, Brahma Sanghita, and Vedanta Sutra, Bhagavat, in Puranas, in Upanishad, everywhere these descriptions are there. Those who are scholarly students, they get information, and the whole thing is summarized in Bhagavad Gita. Therefore, Bhagavad Gita is known also as Gita Upanishad. At the end of every chapter, he'll find these things are written, Gita to Upanishad. It is one of the Upanishads. Read Upanishad, the Bhagavad Gita is also one of the Upanishads. And therefore, Bhagavad Gita is known as Gita Upanishad. If nobody knows the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then how he can be known? If he is not known to the demigods, if he is known to the great sages, then how he can be known? Yes, he can be known. He can be known in this way. When the Supreme Lord comes before you and he reveals himself before you, then he can. You cannot know by your imperfect senses. Our senses are imperfect. There are several times we have described in this meeting that our senses cannot realize the Supreme Truth. Atas Sri Krishna Namadi Navavit Gayam Indriyal. Our senses are so imperfect that simply by expanding the sense power artificially, speculating, we cannot realize. These are described in different way, in different scriptures. So he can be known. How? That is also described. Sevana mukhihi jivhadu svameva spudattava. When you become in a submissive attitude and you chant jivhadu. Jivhadu means the realization begins from the tongue. God realization begins from the tongue. Therefore, the tongue's function is to eat and to vibrate. Tongue. So these two processes, vibration of Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, and eating Krishna Prasad. You cannot allow your tongue to taste anything and everything. If you can control your tongue for eating Krishna Prasad, and if you engage your tongue in vibrating the transcendental sound, Hare Krishna, then Sevana Mukhihi Jivhadu, by this submissive process, that I surrendered my tongue to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then by controlling the tongue, you are controlling all other senses. You go to a straight line from the tongue to the down, all senses will be controlled. And if you cannot control your tongue, then you cannot control your senses. So the first and foremost thing is that you control your tongue. Don't allow your tongue to taste and everything and anything. Krishna has given us so many nice preparations. Day before yesterday, we are present here, we had feasting, everybody who had tasted, so many nice things we have got. Krishna Varadhyamai, Purivare Vyuhajaya, Saprasad Annadilapai. Our tongue is very fastidious. He wants to test this, to test this, test this. But Krishna is so kind that he gives us varieties of prasadam. So you can taste them, you can satisfy your desire. At the same time, you become spiritually advanced. This is a nice process. This is not that in this association you have to do this. You can learn this art and you can have it in your home. You can also prepare such preparation, nice preparation at your home, offered to Krishna. That is not very difficult. We every day prepare an offer to Krishna and chant the mantra Namo Brahmanna Vivaya Go Brahmana Hitayaka Jagat Gitaya Krishnaya Govindaya Namo. That's all. It is not very hard. Everyone can prepare this foodstuff and offer it to Krishna and then take it. And then with family members or with friends, you can sit down and chant before the picture of Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. And live a pure life. Just see the result. If every home, every person takes to this principle of understanding Krishna, it will become, the whole world will become Vaikuntha. Vaikuntha means where there is no anxiety. Vaikuntha, by means without, and Kuntha means anxiety. This world is full of anxiety. Sada samadvijana dhiya asad graha. Because we have accepted this temporary existence of material life, therefore we are always encumbered with anxiety. Just the opposite thing is there in the spiritual world, where the planets are called Vaikuntha. Vaikuntha means without anxiety. We want to be free from anxiety. Everyone is trying to get himself free from anxiety, but he does not know how to get out of this anxiety. This taking shelter of intoxication is no use to get oneself free from anxiety. It is a drug. It is oblivion. Sometimes, for some time, you forget everything. But again, when you come to a consciousness, the same anxiety and same thing are there. So this will not help you. If you want to be free from anxiety, and if you want actually life eternal with bliss and knowledge, then this is the process. This is the process. You have to understand Krishna. Here it is clearly stated that Name Vidu Suragara, nobody can understand. But there is a way. Sevanukhihi Jivadu Swami Vasprasana. This is a process. There are several places in Srimad Bhagavatam this process is described in a different way. Just like in one place it is stated that jnani prayasam mudapasana mantaiva sanamukharitanga bhavadiya vartam jivanti jivanti sanamukharitanga bhavadiya vartam thane sthita sithigatam tanuvanga manohi je prayasa adhika jito pasistai sirapyam. It is very nice, but it is said that adhita, nobody can know. God's another name is Ajita. Ajita means nobody can conquer him. Nobody can approach him. Therefore his name is Ajita. So Ajita becomes conquered. Ajitopi jitopashi. The Lord is unknowable, the Lord is unconquerable, is still he is conquered. How? Nastai thane sthita. Persons, let them remain in their own position, but adopt this principle. What is that? The principle is the jnana prayasam mudapasa. Give up this nonsense speculation, volumes of books. The world is producing every year volumes of books, and they are useless. After 6 months, there is useless thrown. Don't take to that speculative process, this way and that way, this way and that way. Because our senses are limited. How you can have the supreme truth known by these imperfect, blind senses? So, my senses, my speculative power may be greater than you, and another person's speculative power may be greater than me, but nobody can. Here it is clearly stated, Name Suraganabhi. What you are human being, even the Suragana and the great sages, they can't. Therefore, the Brahma says that the jnana prayasam mudapasa, give up this process of so-called knowledge, researching, speculation, give up. Udapasa, Udapasa means traitor. Jnanapyasam Udapasa, Namanta eva. Namanta means just become selfish. Just acknowledge yourself that your senses are limited. You are subordinate even to the material nature, and what to think of God. Everyone is subordinate to the control of the Supreme Lord. Mayadhakshena prakriti satyatmanam. Nobody can be equal or greater than God. Therefore, your qualification should be samadhi. Don't waste your time in speculation. Be samadhi. Jnanapyasam udapasa namanta eva and sanamukharitam bhavadiyabhata. Sanamukharitam means just try to hear about the glories of the Supreme Lord from the mouth of realized soul. Don't go to the unauthorized person. Now how you can know what is the difference between unauthorized and authorized? That you can know also, there is distinction. That is Bhagavad Gita. You see, he is authorized, he is not authorized. The Lord says, evam parampara praptam imam rajasayavidhi. This authority is handed over by disciple success. So that's like Krishna is handing over the authority to Arjuna. And Arjuna says, the param brahma param dhama pavitram paramam bhavan. So if we follow the Arjuna's process, and if we try to understand as Arjuna understood, then the authority is there. It is not very, very difficult to understand his authority. So sthana sthita sutikataṁ sanumāṅamanurhihi. Jnana priyāsam udapāsa namantaya sanumukhita. You have to find out that authority. That's all. That authority you have to find out and remain in your place and try to hear submissively everything Swami was purattara. As soon as you become submissive and hear from authority, then the whole thing is revealed within yourself. God is always ready to be revealed to you. But how does He reveal? He reveals as soon as you become samasi, you become devotee, you become Krishna conscious, you just follow the path traversed by the great Mahajans, great Acharyas, then it is everything known. Although he is not known even to the demigods, even to the great sages, he can be known to you at your home. Ajitopi jitappasi, although he is unconquered. If you adopt this process, so you have to adopt the process only. Otherwise, if you don't adopt the process, there is no alternative. You cannot know, because greater personalities than us, than the human society, the deva, I mean, the suragana, suragana means the demigod, they cannot know. And if you follow this principle, to understand the Supreme Lord, Personality of Godhead, then what will be the result? It is stated here. Jumam ajam anadincha besti loko mahesaram asangmura samatyesu sarva papai pramityata. Sarva papai pramityata. As soon as you understand thoroughly, you can understand thoroughly. This is the process. And how you understand? The standard of understanding, is that the Supreme Lord is anadi. He is the cause of all causes, but he is not caused by any other cause. He has no other cause. Just like Krishna is stated, Ishara Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vigraha Anadi. Ravi Govinda Sarva Karana Karanam. Karanam is cause. And He is the cause of all causes. To understand Krishna, the Supreme Lord, is to thoroughly be convinced that He is the cause of all causes. Jumam Anadi. Anadi means he has no other cause. Sarvaloka Mahesa, and he is the proprietor. He is the master, he is the proprietor of all planets, either in this material world or in the spiritual world. Sarvaloka Maheshwaram Asangamura, not by not accepting blindly. Don't accept blind. You have God. God has given you power of reasoning, power of arguments, but don't argue falsely. The process is, that is also mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita. Tadvidhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya. If you want to understand the transcendental science, then you have to follow this principle. What is that? Tadvidhi pranipatena. You have to surrender you, the same thing. Just like Namantava, unless he becomes submissive, he cannot be a surrendered soul. And where? The pranipat. Where you will find a person that he is, here is a person where I can surrender. Then that means you have to make a little test where to surrender. That much knowledge you must have. Don't surrender to any nonsense. You have to know how that intelligent and nonsense can be found out. That is also mentioned in the Sāsa. That is mentioned in the Kathopanishad. Tadvidhi pranipātena Kathopanishad says that tadvidyānārtham sa guru meva avigacche sotriyam brahmanishtam. This sotriyam means that one he is coming in disciplic succession. And what is the proof that he has come under the disciplic succession? Brahmanishtam. Brahmanishtam means he is fully convinced about the Supreme Absolute Truth. So there you have to surrender. Pranipat. Pranipat means prakṣṭa rūpena nipātam. No reservation. If you find out such person, then surrender. Yes, panipat. And try to serve him, try to please him, and question him, the whole thing. You have to find out such an authoritative person and surrendering unto him. Surrendering unto him means surrendering unto God, because he is the God's representative. But you are allowed to make questions. Not to waste time, but to understand. That is called purification. These are the processes. Everything is there. You have simply to adopt it. But if you don't adopt the process and simply waste our time by intoxication and speculation and all nonsensical activities, that is not possible ever. You never understand what is God. Because God is unnecessary. Not understandable by the demigods and by the great sages. What is your opinion, of course? So, these are the processes. And if we follow asana mula, if you follow the principle and slow but sure, asana mula, without any doubt, if you, that is the prataksam abhagavan dharma. If you follow, you will understand yourself. Yes, I am getting something. It is not that you are in blind. You are blindly following. As you follow the principle, you will understand. Just like if you eat proper nourishing foodstuff, you will feel yourself strength and your hunger satisfied. You haven't got to ask anybody. You will feel yourself. Similarly, if you come to the proper path and if you follow the principle, you will understand. Yes, I am making progress. So pratyakham, in the 9th chapter here, says pratyakham abhagavam dharma susukham. And it is very easy. And you can be in happy mood. And what is the process? You chant Hare Krishna and eat Krishna prasad and study Bhagavad Gita philosophy. Yes, nice musical sound. Is it very difficult? Is it very difficult? Not at all. So by this process, he will be asana mula. Nobody can cheat you. But if you want to be cheated, there are so many cheaters. So don't make a cheater and cheated society. that follows the parampara system that is prescribed in the Vedic literature, as it is recommended by Krishna. Try to understand it from the authoritative source and try to apply it in your life. Then asanam buddha samatthesu. Samatthesu means, matta means those who are eligible for dying, who are disconditioned souls, beginning from Brahma down to the insignificant end, they are all matya. Matya means there is a time when they will die. Samatthesu, among the dying mortals, he becomes the most important. Asangamura, samatthesu. Why? Sarva papai vimutsa. He is free from all kinds of reactions of sinful action. In this world, in this material world, I mean to say, knowingly or unknowingly, we are all always committing sinful acts. So we have to get out of this reaction. And how to get out of it? That is also said in the Bhagavad Gita. Jadhyarthe karmanatra lokam karmavanna. If you do act only for Krishna, Jagga means Vishnu or Krishna. If you only act for Krishna, then you are free from the reaction of anything. Subhasubha, fully. We do something auspicious or inauspicious. But those who are in Krishna consciousness and acting in that way, he has nothing to do with what is auspicious or inauspicious, because he is in touch with the most auspicious Krishna. So therefore, sarva papai pramuchyate, and he becomes free from all the essence of sinful activity. So this is the process. And if we adopt this process, so ultimately we can get in touch with Krishna and our life becomes successful. The process is very simple and everyone can adopt. Thank you. Thank you.